Revelator Aggregator. About a month ago, while watching the only news source that I trust, True News, other than the Bible, that is, which I believe to be the inerrant word of Father God Almighty, while watching True News, I heard the host Rick Wiles say that Kabbalah was that voodoo that Jews do. At the time, I thought this was an accurate and somewhat amusing assessment of Hoogie Boogie Kabbalah. But at the time, I just assumed it was a catchy little turn of phrase that Brother Wiles himself had come up with. After all, he was the man that invented the term Arkinside for the Clinton body count. Then, the other night, while looking for some background photos for my video on BB and Hoogie Boogie Kabbalah Rabbi Kaduri, on a whim I typed the phrase Kabbalah Voodoo that Jews do into a search engine, and immediately I came across a 2014 article from the famous and long-running left-wing Jewish magazine, The Forward. Amazingly enough, and brazenly enough, said article was entitled, The Voodoo That Jews Do. My mind was blown. So I read the article, because I could not believe that a couple of Hoogie Boogie Kabbalists, which is what I assume the two authors of the article are, but I couldn't believe that two Kabbalists would be so out in the open about the black magic and witchcraft nature of their religion, for lack of a better word. Oh, but they were open about it in spades. They did not hide the ball at all. But since this article was so revelatory, and since the name of this channel is Revelator Aggregator, and since the article goes into so much detail about the hoogie boogie nature of both Kabbalah and voodoo, I'm devoting a video to pretty much the entire thing, with only a few sort of extraneous portions cut out. And I don't care if it takes me forever, and I don't care if it's my longest video ever, and I don't care if it takes 3,000 years to upload to YouTube. I will be examining each section of this article, and then I will be providing analysis on the same. Let's go. I promise to do my very best to read this foolishness without a mocking tone. Quote, it's not every day that a voodoo priestess kicks you out of her temple for asking about the lost books of Moses. End quote. As an initial matter, anyone who legitimately serves Yahweh, who roundly condemns witchcraft of any sort, shouldn't be consorting with a voodoo priestess. And two, there's no such thing as the lost books of Moses. That's some pseudo-epigraphical foolishness. Quote, but as we stood in Miriam Chimani's voodoo spiritual temple in New Orleans, asking about the connection between voodoo and Judaism, she grew more and more agitated. End quote. Well, of course she did. 2 points here. One, it's a spiritual war we're in, and she knows for sure which side she's on. She's on the hoogie boogie demonic side. So why would she want to be talking about Yahweh's side? And two, if she is in the know and knows that much of modern day Orthodox Judaism, quote unquote Judaism, is some Babylonian hoogie boogie Kabbalah witchcraft, and she knows that the time's not quite right yet for the witches and the warlocks and the hoogie boogies to be coming out of the groves, then she certainly doesn't want loudmouths like y'all blowing up everybody else's spot. Quote, we left chastened but determined to come back. We had this theory that Judaism and voodoo are not mutually exclusive and may even share historical roots. End quote. If by Judaism you mean the legitimate worship of Yahweh Father God, then no. They don't share any historical roots. However, if you mean hoogie boogie Kabbalah and Babylonian black magic going all the way back to the fallen angels and the Nephilim, then sure, they've got lots of historical connections, bruh. Quote, this article started out as a joke,
on the long drive to New Orleans, and tossed out, "Wouldn't it be funny if we could find a Jewish connection to voodoo?" End quote. Wait, so why were two journalists driving to New Orleans to begin with? Was the forward fixing to cover Mardi Gras or something? But more on this quote-unquote joke ruse later on. Quote, one Google search later, we learned that Louis XIV's Code Noir, a decree meant to regulate interactions between slaves and citizens of the colony, had ordered all the Jews out of Louisiana almost 300 years ago. But as we started exploring the city, Judaism peeked out at every turn. Like Judaism Judaism or Hoogie Boogie Kabbalah Judaism? Quote, voodoo historian Jerry Gandolfo had agreed to an interview with us at his workplace. The New Orleans Historic Voodoo Museum, which his father founded in 1972. End quote. And I bet Gandolfo Sr.'s father was into some hoogie boogie foolishness before him. Here in a minute, we're fixing to see more bloodline hoogie booginess with old Gandolfo. And later on, we'll see even more bloodline hoogie booginess with another of our main characters herein. Quote, Gandolfo had agreed at the last minute to lead a ghost tour. That's a lovely euphemism. Would we like to come? Yes, we would. Quote, Gandolfo pointed out sites of interest, like the former slave barracks added on to the back of stately homes, which today look more like odd balconies. End quote. Gandolfo encouraged us to connect the dots. It was here in these slave quarters that voodoo blossomed in the New World. End quote. And just like the shabby lodgings, Gandolfo said, voodoo hides in plain sight. Your eyes see it, but your brain doesn't. And that right there, ladies and gentlemen, might be the money quote of the whole article. Because if we know one thing about the Illuminized Toogie Boogies that are temporarily in charge of this fallen world, they love hiding stuff in plain sight. I think it has something to do with sympathetic magic or some evil foolishness like that, but don't ask me to explain it. And it's immediately followed with another humdinger. Hollywood has brainwashed us when it comes to voodoo. Those might be the most true, least deceptive words in the entire article. Continuing, the word conjures up hokey images of skeletons, bloody rituals, and late-night cemetery seances. But the spiritual tradition, which originated in West Africa, has a long and fraught history. What the deceptive authors of the article neglect to tell you is that the reputation for bloody rituals and seances is well grounded in fact. In Benin, followers worshipped Mawu Lisa, a supreme god portrayed as a hermaphrodite snake. So nobody should be shocked that the Hoogie Boogies are still trying to program us into some multi-gay, bisexual, gender-fluid, transgender-bending foolishness. And I pity and pray for those poor individuals that suffer from gender confusion. They're just pawns being used by the Hoogie Boogies. Continuing, but they directed their intercessions through lower spirits known as Loa, offering them sacrifices in the hopes of becoming possessed. End quote. That's what I love about this article. They just frankly break down all of this wickedness known as black magic, voodoo, and Kabbalah. American voodoo, related but not identical to Haitian voodoo, dates back to the slave trade, when African slaves arrived in Louisiana to work on sugar plantations. They maintained their own traditions while melding them with those imposed by their captors. Thus, the Loa, aka the Hoogie Boogie demonic Nephilim spirits, each with its own persona and specific attributes, were mapped onto Catholic saints. That's how Legba, keeper of the spirit realm, became Saint Peter, holding the keys to the gates of heaven, aka typical Crowleyan demonic satanic inversion. Quote, "You can't have that big of a population without a fusion," Gandolfo explained. "There is no conflict with being both Catholic and voodoo." Wrong! In fact, Gandolfo went on, non-Catholic voodoo practitioners in New Orleans feel a particular connection with Jews, pointing to a biblical tradition that describes Moses' wife Zipporah as a black woman. They believe the couple's son Pethro was the forefather of the West African creators of voodoo. And by biblical tradition, the authors certainly mean nonsensical pseudo-epigraphical tradition. It does not seem super believable that Moses' wife would have crossed the wasteland of the Sahara to be his bride. We were a little skeptical, but Gandolfo reminded us that Moses' staff famously turned into a snake reminiscent of Mawu Lisa. Yeah, to prove the supremacy of Yahweh to the hoogie boogie Egyptian magicians whose staffs had already turned into snakes. That Gandalf is one slick little pagan. Continuing, still not convinced, but then Gandalf mentioned the 6th, 7th, and 8th books of Moses, secret voodoo sequels to the Pentateuch. Say what? Say what? Say just more hoogie boogie pseudo-epigraphical foolishness, authors. St. Louis Cemetery, nicknamed the City of the Dead. As we meandered through the rows of graves, Gandolfo mentioned his great-great-great-grandmother, Maria Antonia Solis y Perez, the first and only Jew to be buried here. Gandolf discovered his Jewish past while researching Perez, a crypto-Jew from the original Jewish family in Louisiana, who was buried in 1789, the year the cemetery was founded. I'm so glad the authors decided to shed more light on Gandalf's very interesting bloodline. You know who else was purported to be a crypto-Jew? Adam Weishaupt, founder of the Bavarian Illuminati. The St. Louis Cemetery also plays host to the tomb of Hoogie Boogie Voodoo Queen Marie Laveau. Really, it's more of a shrine. Quel surprise. A shrine to a voodoo witch? Surprise, surprise! Beaded Mardi Gras necklaces, vibrant flowers wilting in the sun, liquor bottles, tobacco, candles, gri-gri bags, dolls, apples. It looked like Avril Lavigne's vanity table. The tome itself was covered in the signatures of Laveau's followers, some of whom could not write and so resorted to scrawling X's to make their mark. Oh, they were making their mark all right, you Weasley writers. They were making the mark of the beast. In numerology, X can be a stand-in for 6. X is the 24th letter of the alphabet, and 2 plus 4 equals 6. Therefore, what does XXX really mean? Also, that looks to be a lot of illiterate signatories. Most of those quote-unquote signatures are XXX. Just saying. We each made a wish. For us as Jews, it felt a little sacrilegious. It totally should have, buddy. But then again, was it really so different from praying at the tomb of a rabbi? Maybe not at the tome of a hoogie boogie Kabbalah rabbi. These lovely witches are Viviana Della Rosa and Cinnamon Black. Quote, "We sat down with them in the courtyard behind the Voodoo Museum. Almost immediately, we bonded over Kabbalah." Quel surprise! After explaining our interest in the Judaism voodoo connection, we ask if the monotheism of one contradicts the many spirits of the other. "No, not at all," Della Rosa answered. "In the Kabbalah, you also have the male and female sides of God." I think here it's important to distinguish between the monotheistic nature of true, pure Judaism and the hoogie-boogie pantheism of Babylonian Kabbalah witchcraft. Seagull, one of the authors, whose father is a former professor of Jewish mysticism. Oh, surprise to end all surprises. Another hoogie-boogie bloodline nodded vigorously. One of the central features of medieval Kabbalah is the Tree of Life, a group of 10 attributes that God used to create the universe, half of which are male and half of which are female. The plot thickens. Now we've got the child of a hoogie-boogie Kabbalist going down to meet with hoogie-boogie voodoo priestesses. And y'all really expect me to believe that this story was the product of a joke? Get real! Moving on, this dual-gendered idea of divinity is as fundamental to mystical, reed, Babylonian Judaism as the hermaphrodite Maulisa is to voodoo. Both faiths share a tradition of hoogie-boogie multiplicity within unity. Did y'all just see how they tied goddess worship in with dualism there? Both of which are very false, very pagan, occult teachings. Voodoo practitioners, De La Rosa added, have learned to deceive, to adapt and incorporate the key attributes of each religion, and members of those other religions can sense that. She said, Muslims and Jews frequently attend her voodoo ceremonies in Chicago. Black, whose grandfather was a Baptist minister, used her own religious background to prove the point about voodoo. It's a religion that is very inclusive and not exclusive, she said. Yep, they'll include you right on up to and through the gates of hell with that voodoo. You can believe anything and be a part of their club, just so long as the anything you believe is not that Jesus Christ was the only begotten Son of Yahweh Father God. Entering Sally Ann Glassman's voodoo shop is like stumbling into a Hogwarts potions cupboard gone wild. Nice nod to hoogie-boogie sugar-coated occultism for beginners Harry Potter there. The walls are lined with glass jars containing blah blah blah, but they're also dotted with Jewish symbols, from golden hamsas to amulets warding off the evil eye. And lo and behold, a Tree of Life t-shirt. Glassman, a self-described Ukrainian Jew from Maine, read Ashkenazi Khazarian Eastern European quote-unquote Jew from Maine, presides over Island of Salvation Botanica, a quote magical pharmacy, end quote, that moonlights as a temple. What kind of a temple? A hoogie-boogie black magic voodoo temple? Do they do human sacrifices there? A petite woman dressed in all black save for the neon skulls dotting her socks. Well, doesn't she sound like a righteous sweet little sunbeam? How does a nice quote-unquote Jewish girl become a Haitian voodoo priestess? Her parents were committed atheists, but from a young age she was concerned with the spiritual. She liked to contemplate not things, but unthings, as she called them. Or as I would call them, hoogie-boogie demon Nephilim spirit monsters. Also, y'all need to knock it off with this pretend atheist thing. I bet they were about as atheist as Aleister Crowley. I would love going into sacred spaces. Like, what kind of quote-unquote sacred spaces are we talking? Hoogie-boogie groves or hoogie-boogie high places? Where they do the hoogie-boogie human sacrifices and rituals. A 1995 trip to Haiti introduced her to voodoo, which has its own distinct set of practices, but she doesn't see her chosen path as a departure from quote-unquote Judaism. Of course she doesn't! Asked to describe her practice, she said, "There's some aspects of it that's strictly voodoo. Some of it is strictly Kabbalah and quote-unquote Judaism." Again, not trying to be disagreeable or argumentative, but true monotheistic Judaism is completely antithetical to hoogie-boogie Kabbalah and hoogie-boogie voodoo. Seagull pointed to the Tree of Life t-shirt on the wall. Of course he did. Was there a parallel concept in voodoo? Of course there was. Grand Boy, Glassman explained, is a demon, I mean Loa, closely associated with trees. The sap of life moves up and down it. This sounded a lot like the Hoogie Boogie direct light and the Hoogie Boogie returning light that Kabbalists say travel up and down the Hoogie Boogie tree of life. Even the idea of possession, central to both voodoo and voodoo, is not foreign to Judaism. In the Middle Ages, Hasidic masters rose to prominence by promising to exorcise evil spirits from Jews who had become possessed. In voodoo, possession is not seen as negative. In fact, it is the ultimate goal. And there you have it. Demonic possession is the ultimate goal of voodoo. Not my words, their words. And they're proudly announcing it. And even in the throes of possession, Glassman says she can't hide from her Jewish roots. I launch into an internal dialogue about why I am doing this. She has to tell that nagging inner voice, shut up. Miss Glassman, that nagging inner voice is the God-given discernment that you were bestowed with as a birthright from the Creator. It's meant to protect deceived, lost souls such as yourself from doing self-destructive, idiotic things. And here's some terrifying mess from Hoogie Boogie Gandalf's Hoogie Boogie Voodoo Museum. Don't that just fill you with a warm sense of spiritual warmth? And now, boys and girls, it's time for Illuminized Hoogie Boogie Babylonian Khazarian Kabbalah Demonic Satanic Hollywood to make its inevitable cameo in this messed up story. Other Khazarian quote-unquote Jews have availed themselves of her services. About 2 decades ago, acting as the late Joan Rivers' personal exorcist, Glassman used Enochian magic to expel poltergeists from the comedian's New York apartment. I suspect if old Joan hadn't been messing with Enochian magic herself, she never would have needed somebody to come in and expel any demonic poltergeist from her apartment. We circle back to Miriam Chimani's Hoogie Boogie Black Magic Temple, dead set on finding those non-existent lost books of Moses. After passing live chickens clucking in a corner, statues of Jesus and Mary, a Russell Stover heart-shaped Elvis chocolate box, hundreds of dollars in small bills, and a Kool-Aid offering, we huddled in front of her bookshelf. It was an occultist's dream, Aleister Crowley, and I've been wondering when that demonic advocate of child sacrifice would rear his ugly head. Continuing, Louis de Clermont. The pages of their books were dotted with Hebrew letters, which were in vogue among the occultists of the earlier 20th century. Again, for this whole story to have started out as a joke, y'all seem to know an awful lot about this Hoogie Boogie stuff. But maybe you just did your homework. We never did find the secret non-existent books, but Chimani had some insight to offer. Of course she did. She advised us, search within your own anatomy. That's what the Kabbalistic Tree of Life is. The idea is to find the answers within yourself. Translation? By all means, lean on your own understanding and don't seek the divine wisdom of Father God or his discernment. Hey, maybe ask some Hoogie Boogie monsters to help. I strongly rebuke every single bit of that horrible advice in the name of Father God. The Hoogie Boogie priestess was alluding to the Kabbalists' false teaching that the Tree of Life is modeled on human anatomy. Oh, do you study Kabbalah? Seagal asked. I don't need to, Chimani scoffed. Because it's all one big messed up devil-worshipping Illuminati family as far as she's concerned, Seagull. We couldn't get her to say anything more, without paying her, that is. Her going rate is $100 per consultation. We declined. The secret, quote-unquote, Jewish history of voodoo would remain a secret. And that's why Hoogie Boogie Babylonian Kabbalah is the identical twin of Hoogie Boogie Babylonian Voodoo. The end. Quick editor's note, I know I said St. Louis Cemetery instead of St. Louis Cemetery earlier. I know St. Louis is correct. Don't write me a bunch of comments, please. Father God bless you all. Jesus Christ saves. And stay in the positive power of the Almighty Holy Spirit.